slow. It might take me a while to get to where I wanna go. I might try your patience, hey, even if I did, I hope you will remember I'm just like every other kid. I'm not the wheels beneath me, that's just the way I roll. Whatever you've been told, I never fit the mold. I'm not the braces that you see, they're only just one part of me. It's taken work, believe me, but here I am completely. I might speak a different language, and I know without a doubt it might be hard to understand, it might be hard to figure out.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Regional Dean of the University of Illinois College of Medicine, Peoria Chair of Easter Seals Central Illinois Board of Directors, Dr. Meenakshi Iyer, and Easter Seals Central Illinois President and CEO, Melissa Riddle.
Thank you. Before we move on with tonight's program, please join me in thanking the Peoria Civic Center and Crack Pepper for deliciously recreating a Scott family favorite meal. It was simply wonderful, wouldn't you agree? Thank you. I know that Mark and Jody have insisted that tonight's celebration be all about kids and families of Easter Seals, Central Illinois, and not to include a lot of personal accolades. However, it is impossible to talk about Easter Seals without acknowledging the impact Mark and Jody have had on the organization. And it is impossible not to go off script when you're celebrating Mark and Jody and Easter Seals. So Mark, I learned that from you. So, both Easter Seals and Mark and Jody, their passion with purpose, drive to make a positive impact and difference in the lives of everyone they touch, their humility and commitment to serve, and their immense positive energy and enthusiasm, the joy that they bring to everyone around them serves as a motivation to us all. So Mark and Jody, thanks for being an inspiration, a role model. You guys rock, and so does Easter Seals. For more than 36 years, their tireless efforts have helped children and families reach significant milestones, some of which, upon receiving the news of their diagnosis, they didn't dare dream possible.
Mark and Jody's passion for our kids and families is immense and really is just an incredible thing to witness. They take the time to speak with and get to know families, understand their individual stories, and use that personal connection to fuel their steadfast support of Easter Seals Illinois' mission and vision, a world in which all children are 100% included and 100% empowered. Their compassion and desire to make a difference is both commendable and inspiring, and continues to be extremely relevant. While remaining committed to providing best-in-class pediatric therapies such as physical, occupational, feeding, and speech, Easter Seals Central Illinois is one of the leading downstate providers of autism services, a prevalent lifelong condition where early diagnosis and treatment is critical. Around the time Mark and Jody began their journey at Easter Seals in 1988, autism rates in children in the United States were roughly 1 in 2,000. 3 decades later, in 2024, 1 in 36 children are diagnosed with autism. Mark and Jody's dedication to Easter Seals Central Illinois through volunteerism, board governance, fundraising, advocacy, and their personal philanthropy has helped provide countless families with not only much-needed treatment, but hope to never stop believing. As a token of appreciation, we have a special gift for Mark and Jody to remember tonight, which is being delivered by our friends, Jossie, Gia, and Jordan. Mark and Jody. Oh, yay. Mark and Jody, thank you for your devoted servant leadership to Easter Seals Central Illinois.
And as Mark and Jody say, it's all about the kids and families. From long-lasting bonds formed years ago, to new friendships recently made, it's a family's journey that motivates them to continue their unwavering commitment to Easter Seals and the transformational work happening every day.
Believing is ability.
Believing is never giving up.
Believing to me is having trust and kindness and trust and other people to help us achieve the goals that we have in life.
At the very beginning, walking in the doors, and I didn't know what to expect. I was just kind of scared. Very quickly, I was encouraged by the friendly faces and the helpful people we found when we got here.
The way we used to walk in here, and we were accepted. Nobody judged us. We were not different. Everybody loved us. And that in itself taught us the biggest lesson in life, is that you just have to keep moving on.
When a parent walks through these doors here at Easter Seals, at the conclusion of their initial meeting here at Easter Seals, each and every one of them walk out of this door with that sense of hope.
Went from being a scary thing to being something I look forward to all the time. Just knowing that they heard me and cared about me and that I would be able to get through the challenges.
We're all dealt our own deck of cards in life, and it's all a matter of how you decide that you're going to play that hand of cards.
Having good support is a big part of that. Places like Easter Seals, I think that's a big part of playing the hand you're dealt is the support you have around you.
We didn't know early on what kind of future he would have. Therapy session through exhausting therapy session, you know, now he is functioning, and we do see how Easter Seals had a part in that.
That Matthew woman before was scared, overwhelmed, confused, but now, thanks to what Easter Seals has done, I'm hopeful and I'm excited and I'm ready to see what life has to offer.
Easter Seals has given me my life, my opportunity to serve our community, but most importantly, be the best husband, the best father, the best son that I can be to those who love me the most.
We were told that he was never going to walk or talk or eat, and that we probably weren't going to have him much longer than a year, and he's 24 years old.
Easter Seals let me eat. Easter Seals let me walk. Easter Seals let me talk. Easter Seals let me.
And that's why you don't stop believing.
Don't stop believing says it all. Each and every day, we can all achieve our dreams. There's nothing stopping us. Don't stop believing in your passions, your love, and your hope for the future.
We don't stop believing, and that we don't give up, that you just keep going. Just keep believing, I guess, is what I would say, because there can be a future, there can be progress, there can be hope.
Don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. That's all you're gonna get right there, I promise.
Now, welcome to the stage from Limestone Community High School, Stacy Seals and Tara Stout.
Good evening. I am Tara Stout, one of the faculty advisors at Student Council at Limestone High School, and with me is my co-advisor, Stacy Seals. We're here tonight to talk to you about our involvement with Easter Seals and Mark and Jody, but first, because we're teachers, we're going to teach you about circles. I'm pretty sure you all know what it means to be within someone's circle. Also, since we're all here tonight, I feel like I can safely assume you might know Mark and Jody Scott. And if you have some free time while you're online, maybe give a Google to the Limestone Strategic Plan, and you'll be able to figure out why we're a part of each other's circle. That plan states that our goal is to implement programs and initiatives that celebrate diversity and encourage a sense of belonging among all members of the school community. This sense of belonging that celebrates all walks of life that come through our doors at the Rock aren't just pretty words. They're a way of doing things that permeates the soul of what it means to be a Rocket. Typically, you might think of your circle as a tight little connection, but if you start to think about a circle being able to expand as you radiate out from the center, you might just get why the Scots celebrate Limestone and why the Rocket Rowdies consider Mark and Jody as one of our own.
Our students at Limestone come from families that run the gamut of socioeconomic spectrum, from relying on public assistance to owning multiple vacation homes. Our students' academic experiences range from the life skills, like learning how to regulate emotions, to college-credited core classes, to an award-winning welding program. We welcome everyone that walks through our doors and into our circle. At Limestone, our value is to celebrate each individual for the gifts that they are to our family every day, as well as during our two-week annual hyper-focused Easter Seals campaign. Although they're not residents of our district, Mark and Jody have expanded their circle to embrace ours, our very diverse population, and to celebrate successes alongside each other.
During our Easter Seals weeks, the Scots are a fan favorite of the Limestone family, especially during our opening assembly. And I'm not sure if any of you have ever made the decision to give Mark a microphone, but we do it every year. And every year, he fires up our student body by shining a light on the wild amounts of money that they raise as a collection of teenagers. But he also recognizes the importance of how our students embrace the children and families of Easter Seals as one of our own. Because at Limestone, that's just what we do, because it's part of our core. Just like what Mark and Jody do, because it's part of who they are. All of us have felt the warmth of the light that shines upon us by being part of Mark and Jody's circle, because that means they're cheering us on. They're letting us know they're on our team. We are honored to be included in the celebration of Mark and Jody and their dedication to sharing the message of Easter Seals, because it really is a full circle moment. Just as they have humbly recognized the selfless service of the Easter Seals staff and the incredible inspiration of the families of Easter Seals and the generosity of the Limestone community, we want to not so humbly turn just a bit of that encompassing love back on Mark and Jody. Here's a peek into what Easter Seals is like at Limestone, thanks in large part to the background encouragement from Mark and Jody.
Limestone High School, we are the Rockets.
We're a small town, but we think big and we aim high.
Shooting for the stars, we never stop believing.
Just like former Rocket Jim Thome, we like hitting it out of the park.
Could it be? It is out of here! Number 400 for Jim Thome!
For the past 48 years, Limestone has been soaring with Easter Seals Central Illinois,
raising over $1.2 million to support their life-changing services for children and families.
Earlier this year, we hit a milestone, raising over $90,000.
Showing that the sky is the limit with the highest one-year total ever.
From teeter-totter-a-thons to three-on-three basketball tournaments and the Rocket Man pageant,
Limestone students bring passion and put all their energy into this timeless flight.
All in support of these kids and their families.
Our school, like Easter Seals Central Illinois, is committed to helping students become independent, lifelong learners.
Ready for the challenges of tomorrow.
Preparing today's students for these challenges is our mission.
Along this journey, we focus on helping others.
We believe as a community, we can overcome any obstacle.
We know it's better to give than to receive.
And we are dedicated to making a difference for these Easter Seals families.
Believing we can reach for the stars and nothing will hold us back.
Rocket graduates never leave the Easter Seals community.
As Rockets, we strive to travel to new frontiers every new year,
raising more money for the families of Easter Seals,
helping the kids of Easter Seals know they can launch their future,
their dreams,
and their ability to not have anything deter their exploration in this trip we call life.
Fly high, dream big,
we are the Limestone Rockets. Rockets.
We really mean it when we say everyone is welcome at the Rock. We invite all of you to come to our Easter Seals assemblies next spring.
Yeah!
And you get to hear Mark on the microphone. That's something we always do, and so does Mark. But this next part is a bit of a surprise for both Mark and Jody, because we really mean it when we say Mark and Jody are treasured parts of our Limestone family. They are our first ever distinguished honorary alumni.
Thank you.
This award will become a regular recognition of someone who embodies the value of intentional inclusion and welcoming diversity. It's a highlight to their unwavering commitment to include and support everyone in their circle. They are each receiving a lifetime pass to any LCHS event, and we also had our student council, as well as the entire senior class, sign these football jerseys welcoming them as alum that was presented to them by alum Peyton McSimoff. Mark and Jody, thank you for including us in your circle, and we officially welcome you as our distinguished honorary alumni. Congratulations on your much-deserved honor.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome daughters of Mark and Jody, Jenna Coburnus and Allie Scott.
First, thank Molly. During our dress rehearsal today, she did give us a forewarning that that was going to be occurring. So thank you for the preparation prior to our speech today. So, all right, may we proceed. Good evening. My name is Allie Scott, and on behalf of Jenna and I, we would like to welcome and thank you for your contributions to the 33rd Easter Seals Tribute Dinner in honor of our parents. Many of you have traveled far, and we are very grateful for that. We are thrilled to celebrate Easter Seals and the community that our parents were welcomed into 36 years ago. What's remarkable about Easter Seals is it is so much more than a charitable organization. It is a lifeline for families in need of support. Our parents saw how children with disabilities were able to access life-changing care and feel a part of something bigger. As I stand here today, I share that Easter Seals has become our family, and we would love to take you down memory lane. We'll start with our early years. Our parents would bring us to Easter Seals and tuck us away in Joette Blakesley's office. Don't worry, we had our McDonald's Happy Meals and we were totally content with our Mary-Kate and Ashley movies. As we grew up, we started to attend events like Lose Your Training Wheels and the Easter Seals Fashion Show. Activities like filling silent auction baskets and doing raffle tickets became very common. In high school, my dad would pull me out of school and take me to the limestone closing ceremonies. This was a highly anticipated event, as many of you saw on the video that was just played, where the students would be raising funds for Easter Seals. It was very highly anticipated. My dad was so excited in the weeks leading up to that, and he was constantly blown away by the students surpassing their goals. At that event, my dad was the ultimate hype man. My senior year of high school, I got involved with the Penguin Project. Shout out to those penguins that have blessed us with their presence here today. Fast forward to college. Easter Seals provided me with my first big girl internship. I will admit, my parents may have pulled a few strings there. Now that we've become adults, and Jen and I have lived in multiple cities, we truly recognize the community that comes with Easter Seals. And I can't forget one last important event of the year, the highly anticipated Black and Blue Ball. And yes, we do have many friends who are constantly asking for the invite. We truly do not know a life without Easter Seals. This is a testament to not only the authentic community that comes with Easter Seals, but also the relationships that you are forming with each and every one of us. Jenna and I have now grown, and as we were first approached with being tonight's, our parents were first approached with being tonight's honorees, the initial answer was no. For our parents, it has never been about recognition. Being in the spotlight is not something that they look for, regardless of how outgoing they may appear. However, as Steve had shared earlier, after additional thought and recognizing that it was an opportunity to recognize the kids, they very happily agreed to be involved. So while our parents may be the honorees tonight, the true heroes are the kids and families of Easter Seals.
Our family has been touched over the years by so many different families. We could stand up here all night and talk about each and every family that we have encountered. However, if you take a look around the room tonight, the stories tell themselves. There are a couple families that have forever changed our hearts. We would be remiss if we did not mention them. Christy, Chad, and Pate.
You got it.
You have changed our lives and our hearts forever. Peyton, as you saw, is one example of what this incredible organization is capable of. He has defied every single odd in life. Woo! That's what my dad would do. In 2014, our dad decided that just going to events was not enough. It was at that time that we as a family began 50 for 50. What started as a goal to run 50 races in 50 weeks, raising $50,000, turned into so much more. Now, I'm not sure the Scott girls truly understood what we were up against. Historically, not runners. We thought one 5K per week, how bad could it be? Well, take into consideration the Central Illinois winters, and the fact that there is not one 5K per week in the area, realistically, one 5K a week was not in the cards. Even when she did not run, my mom was there at almost every single race. She would drive him to rural towns on Saturday mornings for yet another race. The red 50 for 50 shirts became recognizable all around the state. The four of us definitely did not expect the overwhelming support. In 1 year alone, the goal of $50,000 was almost doubled. Not to mention, he well exceeded 50 races, ending around 65 total 5Ks in just 1 year. Jordan Bricks and the incredible army behind him. There is rarely an Easter Seals event that Jordan will miss. As you saw, he's here tonight. At every event, Jordan never passed up an opportunity to find us and take a picture. As if that was not enough, at the next event, he would find us again and give us that picture. This is yet another example of the footprint Easter Seals has left on our hearts. Even though he's an ISU fan, we can't hold that against him. The relationship we have with this organization is more than that of a volunteer. If there's one thing our parents have taught us, it is what it means to go into the world with an open heart. In closing, if there's one thing that we hope you take from tonight, it is don't stop believing, if you haven't noticed. The phrase is more than just the chorus of a song. It is something the families at Easter Seals rely on daily. While many associate those words with journey, our family associates them with the Penguins, and we are so excited to see their special performance later tonight. Here's a glimpse into the Scott family. And, by the way, we have to take the opportunity to hype up the preseason number one picked Bradley Briggs. Kicking off their season in this very building Monday night. If you know us, you know we love the Bradley Briggs. And Mom and Dad, we love you more.
Oh, gosh. He's one of the most passionate guys I know.
A man of deep feeling, he can bring a very high level of energy and passion that is really contagious.
If you ever go to a Bradley basketball game, Mark
every fiber of his being is engaged in the game. He exudes passion and he wears it on his sleeve.
I just believe in making a difference, and sometimes passion gets involved in that.
I always tell my players there's energy givers and takers, and he, Mark Scott's a giver, a passionate guy that loves people. Some people find their passion, some people don't, but I think when you meet Mark Scott, you know he's passionate about Easter Seals, he's passionate about his family, his wife, I think Bradley basketball, and in the city of Peoria.
The passion for Bradley basketball is obviously different than the passion for Easter Seals.
The children and the staff are our passion that keep us going.
507 East Armstrong, each and every day there's a miracle happens, right? I want those kids to have that same opportunity that my kids have and other kids have.
It's hard for them to come through these doors and to receive the therapy, but we're fortunate that we have a place like this that they make milestones happen each and every day.
You have to believe it for other people to believe it. And I would say Mark and Jody, their belief has a way of getting other people to believe. So whether you're a coach or an administrator, you're working for the Easter Seals to raise money for this wonderful cause, sometimes people may come through our doors and they don't have the belief, they don't have the faith. The thing about believing is that it just gives you the sense that there's something better on the other side if you just keep pushing through and be resilient.
You want to enjoy the journey, and I think that is don't stop believing, keep believing, keep taking it one day at a time. You may have a setback here and there, but you just got to keep pushing through and trust the process, the little things, and eventually the outcome is what you get.
It says it all. Don't ever stop believing, because this place makes magic.
Mark and Jody's passion for life, passion to help, passion to serve, have rubbed off on me every single day.
Peoria needs a Mark and Jody Scott, because they're not going to give up when things are rough. They're going to press on. They're going to pursue the hope that is to come.
I do it because I think it's important. I don't enjoy asking you for money. I really don't. I mean, I hate it, actually. But I know we got to do it. The model is not sustainable on its own. We have to have scholarship in the development side to be able to continue to serve those kids each and every day.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Easter Seals Ambassador Matthew Mormon.
Don't stop believing. A phrase that has always been invaluable to me and my family. In a time where giving up seemed like the only option, it was Easter Seals that showed us what don't stop believing really means. I was only 4 years old when my parents first began to realize that I struggled processing the world around me in a typical way. If we took a different way home from the grocery store, I'd break down screaming. If I spilled some water on the floor, I would slam my body into the wall, crying and hitting myself. My parents desperately wanted to help me cope with the world around me, but felt lost and out of options. Meanwhile, I felt trapped in a cycle I didn't understand and couldn't escape. Coming to Easter Seals changed all of that. Through occupational therapy, I was diagnosed with Asperger's syndrome and sensory processing disorder. After much hard work and unconditional love, my therapists and the community at Easter Seals gave me the ability to understand the emotions I was feeling and to process them in a healthy way. The tools and support those at Easter Seals gave me equipped me to lead a typical life, something that seemed impossible for so long. Now I have the opportunity to give this support back to the community through my work at the Christian Center in Peoria. Thanks to Easter Seals and its wonderful volunteers, including tonight's honorees, I am no longer the same person who first walked through that door 18 years ago. I am now and forever will be an ambassador of Easter Seals. Tonight, I have the distinct honor of being the voice of thousands of children who have been encouraged to believe by these two wonderful people. On behalf of the children and families Easter Seals has been called to serve, please join me in welcoming to the stage our honorees for the 33rd Easter Seals Tribute Dinner, Mark and Jody Scott.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this, I did it my way.
All right, where are we at? I don't feel like that's... Oh, yeah, here we go. I got to turn the page. Wow. She didn't know about this. Where do we start? There's so much to talk about over the past 36 years. Jody and I discussed what song we wanted to walk up, and we never really came to an answer. And Tuesday morning, I woke up, and I was walking through the bedroom door, and it like hit me all of a sudden. I didn't share this with her or any of my family members, just the staff. I sent them a text and told them what I wanted to do. But it says so much about us and me and Hayes. This is Hayes, by the way, I apologize, but anyhow. But that song was her dad and my father-in-law's favorite song. And I felt like that would be a way for him to be with us here tonight. So that's where that song came from. So there's kind of an elephant in the room, and I wasn't going to talk about it. And I'm going to get through it really quick, okay? So I got to get rid of it. April 30th, my mother was diagnosed with brain cancer. She said to me, I just need to be there for you that night. That's all I want. She's still with us. She's still with us. But she couldn't come tonight. So I didn't think I could do it. I didn't think I could get through it. And I did. And so here's Ruthie. She's going to see the video. What Jenna didn't tell you, she's 7 months pregnant. She told me a couple months ago, I'm not only going to be here for your deal, but I'm going to see that grandbaby, my great-great-great-grandbaby. And so, anyhow, thank you.
Hey, we're right in the middle of something here. What are you doing?
Well, Mark, I've got something important I need to say before you continue. In honor of Mark and Jody's family theme of Don't Stop Believing, I'm excited to share that a new Don't Stop Believing Endowment Fund has been established with the Easter Seals Central Illinois Foundation in honor of tonight and Mark and Jody's dedication. And not only that, but two anonymous donors have generously agreed to donate up to $100,000 in matching funds for all gifts received tonight.
Woo!
I would love to see everyone grab an envelope from your table or grab your phone and scan the QR code to make a donation to this newly established fund. All envelopes can be placed in this boombox, which will be located in the lobby at the help desk at the top of the elevator.
Hey, great job, Tom. This is Top Gun. Mr. Top Gun right here. Hayden, we love you more than anything in the world, and we appreciate all you do for us. All right, here we go. What an incredible, incredible evening this has been. So where do we... All right, I got to regroup here because that really got me messed up. Where are we? I previously mentioned that there are so much to talk about. First, I'd like to thank a very important person, Mr. Dale Berkland. In 2000, we went to him. By the way, Steve left one piece out. Steve and I were the committee for this. Like, and I never ever thought that I would be part of this. But anyhow, he said, Steve, we would love to do it, but I can't do it alone. We have to include Shirley. And that's where Easter Seal started in 2000, where we included not only the honoree, but their spouse. And I feel that was very important. A round of applause for that. There's a guy in the room tonight. When I first got started, I don't mean to leave her hanging. Hey, by the way, so I forgot one thing to do. So my daughter got married last June, okay? And we're a team. And so I'm going to bring my team up. So come on up, team. Come on up. You can come, too. You're part of the team, finally. Hurry up. Let's go. You're out. Hurry up. No, hurry up. I'm going to keep going. But anyhow, there's a gentleman in this room that was my mentor, okay? And I'm not saying that I always wanted to be like him, but I wanted to be like him, and I wanted to make a difference, and that's Mr. John Beers. He has committed so many years to not only Easter Seals, but so many organizations in Central Illinois, and they don't get any better. So give him a quick round of applause. So I decided tonight to stand in the front, right? And everybody kept saying, where's Jody? Where's Jody? It's like she's on the inside because she tends to carry into conversations and I know how to just say, hey, thanks for coming and all that. So, but I'm just telling you, this has been a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. Like I was nervous that she would leave me through this process. But she has been unbelievable. She is my rock. We've done so much together, and I don't know how I could have got through this journey without her, but we made it. We're here tonight, and we're only here for one reason. And I think you caught that in the video, that I hate, literally, that's a bad word, I apologize. But I dislike asking people for money, right? Because all I do is get asked. We get letters every day. There's so many, many organizations that are so worthy and are needed in Central Illinois. But this is a special one. I don't ask a lot. But tonight I'm going to ask, and we'll get to that just here in a little bit. But it's just incredible. I had a couple people. I got a card from Maggie Gets tonight, okay? And it opened up and it was a picture of Jody and I from like 10 years ago. It's just, it's so much. And I'll get back to that. Anyhow, how are we doing on the over-under? We want to thank all of our friends and family that traveled from all over the country, Texas to Florida, to be here with us this evening. It's so overwhelming, the support that we've received and the comments that we've received. And I just want to thank you so much for that. All right, now I'm switching to my note cards. Hold on. Here we go. So the reason that we're here tonight and the reason that Peoria is what Peoria is because of Caterpillar Incorporated. I know that there's been a lot of conversation about decisions that were made and this and that. But Joe is my friend. And I called him up. He couldn't be here tonight because they have an executive deal going on down in Dallas tonight. What you guys don't know is Joe is still on our board of directors. He is the COO of Caterpillar living in Dallas, and he's still on our board of directors, and he was on our call a week ago Thursday for the executive meeting at 7:30. That's the commitment that that man has to not only Central Illinois, but to Easter Seals, and give him a quick round of applause. Steve and Mo. I met Steve 36 years ago. Obviously, I wasn't with Jody at that particular time, but we were getting close to that time. And we went to high school together. We never dated, and we ran into each other at Tony C's out at Westlake one night, and the rest is history, right? And so, but Steve and Mo, 18 children. I think he told me the other day he just had his 33rd grandchild, okay? I love the guy. I love that couple. They're incredible. Been such a pillar for Central Illinois. Joette, Steve, and Krista. Yeah, thank you. Joette, Steve, and Krista. To see Krista Bieneman tonight in that video means so much to me. She's that unsung hero that stayed behind the scenes and kept us all together. Our development team through the years have been incredible. We've had so many great leaders in the development team. And our development team is what kept us going each and every day. But I don't remember what year it was, but we formed it in 2011, but we started talking about it. But Doug at that time was on the board, and he said, we've got to get this thing going with a foundation or we're not going to be sustainable. I'm telling you guys, I had the opportunity to be the chairman of the board from 2008 to 2010, and I don't know if you guys remember, but those were some pretty tough years, and we got through it. I mean, it was really, really tough. This morning, I was writing these things down to talk about tonight, and I got a text from Bob Gallagher, who used to be the comptroller at Caterpillar. He and Judy, most incredible people. They used to go literally with Steve and Mo to Aldi's and Pekin and buy 5 and 6 grocery carts worth of groceries to help support their 18 kids. That's what kind of people they were, or they are. And so anyhow, he sent me a text and congratulated me and said that there were, you know, so many of you have said to us, there's nobody more worthy. That's not true. There's so many people that are so worthy. But the fact that we can bring attention to the mission and make a difference, that's why we're here tonight. But Bob filled in for me because at the particular time, I was the president of the Braves Club, and I didn't see how I could run, be president of the Braves Club, run my own company, and be chairman of the board of the Easter Seals. So Bob filled in for a year, and that was fantastic, and I just appreciate that so much. Staff, you guys saw it. We have the most incredible staff you can ever ask for. They can go other places, okay, because we can't do what others do, but they stay because we are family at Easter Seals, and we all treat each other with respect, and you don't get lost in the shuffle. And I'm not criticizing any other organization. I'm just saying that we've been here for 100 years, and we're a very, very special organization. Meenakshi and Melissa. First of all, Meenakshi putting up with Guha each and every day. Come on, give me a break. The Energizer Bunny. He's got more energy and more passion for everything in the world. But she is our chairperson of the board, and she's done a fantastic job. Melissa came in with a very, very, very difficult task to follow Steve Thompson. And I told Melissa, not only did I, but Joe and others told Melissa, we are not going to allow you to fail. And I feel like we've held that up. And you know what? She is making a difference. She's brought together a team that's doing an incredible job, improving efficiencies, and making a difference each and every day. And so a round of applause. So my kids talked about the Mormons and the McSimoffs, and there's just so many, right? It's the families. It's so important to be there for those families. And I'm going to show you that here in a second. It's like the Lord works in mysterious ways. Like, I knew nothing about these videos, and I get an A++. And I'm just telling you right now, I get an A++. I never asked any questions. I didn't have a clue what was going to happen tonight with the videos or the limestone or the record or any of that. I knew nothing. I never asked any of that. I asked a lot of other questions. I wore some of them out, right? But I never asked those questions. How are we doing? Are we over yet? I don't care. Julie Whitty said I could talk as long as I want because that's why everybody's here to listen. True, Whitty? All right. Limestone. So I've had a lot of success in life. I've miserably failed. And when I say miserably failed, I mean miserably failed. I have stood in front of 800 kids in a packed Limestone High School telling them that I am going to get them national recognition because their story is no other anywhere. You tell me where you can find a high school raising money, kids supporting kids for 48 consecutive years. 48 consecutive years raising $1,387,124.47. Tell me right now. I want to hear it. Raise your hand if you know anybody. But I'm going to tell you right now, if you know somebody in the national media, tell them to call me. Because this is a story that needs to be told. We're coming up. We have got to get this out there. There's no other high school like it that is supporting kids, giving back to kids. Biggs and Allie. You know, I'm so blessed to have raised two kids to get it. it's you can lead them to water, but you can't make them drink these days, right? I'm proud to say that my kids get it, and they're making a difference each and every day in the jobs that they're doing. Give them a round of applause. Bradley community. So it's, I'm gonna, like, there's 900 people here, right? And so I'm just gonna tell you right now, I never got kicked out of a Bradley game. I left, but I never got kicked out. And I will tell you that that situation would have never, ever, 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 ever happened if Mr. Chris Reynolds was here. Because he is making a difference. And I'm going to talk about that for just a second. Bradley's taken some really hard black eyes, guys. But I'm going to tell you right now, this guy right here, stand up real quick. I know you hate it. Just stand up. Stand up. John Michael stepped up. We're going to get this ship turned around because, listen, Peoria isn't Peoria without Bradley. And we are going to make a difference. We got the basketball and athletic program rolling. I mean, we got great kids coming to Peoria, and we are going to rock and roll, and we're going to win the NCAA tournament. Right, Coach? All right. Throw that picture up. So, Jody and I met WMBD on Tuesday at the center to do a story. And we were sitting there right in front of the PDC truck, the Coulter family over here. Give them a round of applause. And I looked up, and I've said this 1,000 times, literally. The miracles happen each and every day in those two doors at 507 East Armstrong. And the fact that that came out tonight in the videos that I knew nothing about tells you how important those two doors are at 507 East Armstrong. Throw the next video up. So I went to lunch yesterday in Morton at the sushi restaurant with my good friend Roger Kaler. I try to get over there once every couple, 3 weeks and take him to lunch. He was one of my mentors, along with many, many other people in the Peoria community that helped me get where I'm at. And I don't know, I just felt like I needed to stop at the center and just say, hey, what's going on, you know? So I walked in the front door, and I went upstairs, and I talked to the development department, and they didn't want anything to do with me because they're tired of listening to me. And so I went over to the boardroom, and we had a chili cook-off, and so I talked to Brittany for a little bit. And I came back down, and I was going down the steps, and as I came down the steps, I saw this little guy. Let me introduce to you my new friend, Cruz. So, you see those wheels and that technology? The difference between 36 years ago and today and what we're doing and how we're improving the lives is absolutely incredible. So I just stood there for a minute and kind of took it all in and watched the therapy session. And I got to chit-chatting with the mother, right? So then I said, hey, gotta get a picture, because I'm kind of known for that. Whether we're in Peoria, or at a Northwestern game, or in Colorado, or any kids with disabilities, when I see them, I always ask them, can I get a picture? So I got a picture with him, and the mother says to me, can you send that to me? I said, absolutely. So I sent her the picture. I'm walking out those two front doors. and my phone starts blowing up. So I get in the car, and I look at the text, and I have a new best friend. She sends me all these pictures of Cruz and their family and their story. I asked her if I could share the story. Not sure she's really comfortable with it yet, so I'm not going to talk about it. But I am going to tell you that the first thing she said to me is the love that she feels each and every time she walks through those two front doors that they just showed you. Because Judy and Sherry are our two gals in the, our receptionist, or whatever we call them these days, right? Greeters, whatever. But they're unbelievable. You walk in, they smile. And that's what we do at Easter Seals. We make people feel at home. We make them feel like family. The therapist that was there, and I'm terrible with names, and I feel so bad that I can't recognize her, but she's been with us for 16 years. And she said to her, "Do you know who that is?" And she said, "No." She said, "Tomorrow night, they're going to recognize he and his wife at Easter, or at the Civic Center for the tribute dinner." And it's just so much. So here's where we're going. Many events like this, guys like Matt Bird, where's Matt Bird at? Stand up, Bird. I can't see him. Even if he's standing up, we wouldn't see him. But that's all right. There he is. This guy is the greatest auctioneer ever. He has raised millions of dollars at not only at Black and Blue Ball, but at Claybird. And not only for Easter Seals, but St. Jude and many other organizations. And he gets it. Like, he has a real job, but he does this to help the kids, and he does a fantastic job. So I've received a lot of calls and text from a lot of people over the last 6 months saying, "Are you going to do a paddle raise?" No. I'm not a paddle raise guy. I just feel like it guilts people into raising their paddle when they shouldn't raise it. But I'm going to tell you, there's a card, multiple cards on your table that you can fill out. And you can give from your donor fund or your foundation or whatever and make a significant difference by what Hayden said tonight. And or if you just want to make a contribution and scan your phone, you can make a difference. The number's going to come out here shortly. Our goal was to raise $1.2 million and net $1 million because of all the other expenses that are involved in putting on an event like this tonight. But a week ago Thursday during the executive board meeting, I said to Melissa, "What's our payout this year?" She said $971,000 from the foundation to the operating fund. We can only do so many special events because we can only afford so much staff. And the only way we can continue to be Easter Seals Central Illinois is to continue from the support. And so I'm asking you tonight, they always say give till it hurts, and I'm not asking you to do that. But there's a lot of people that are here this evening that can do it, and a little bit goes a long way. I built my business on nickels and dimes because nickels and dimes turn into quarters and dollars. And it's the same thing tonight. We need to raise this money for these kids so that we continue to be sustainable to do what we do each and every day. So I'm way off course. I know I'm way over. But.
Huh? Done?
All right, I want everybody to turn around and look to the back of the room. And you're gonna see a bunch of yellow shirts. We're gonna bring them on in. Ladies and gentlemen, the Penguins! All right, we're going to pretend like we're at a Bradley game. I want everybody to get them up. On your feet. So when we started this, I said, hey, Andy and Kathy, what they've done is incredible. And I said, we want the Penguins to perform tonight. But I don't want just the Penguins. I want every Penguin that will come. I don't care when they graduated or whatever. So we have, where's Naomi? There she is. Look at the smile on her face. Naomi was one of our first Penguins in 2004. Huh? Look at that smile. All right. Daniel, raise your hand. This is Daniel Van Buskirk. Daniel just moved out and he is independently living in his own home in Peoria, Illinois. Give him a round of applause. Not only that, his mom and dad are out of town for a week, so he is gonna let it happen. All right, Andy, are we ready? Hey, let's let Pekin and East Peoria hear us. You ready? Let's go.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere.
Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going
anywhere. Cheap perfume, for a smile they can share.
How about that? Let me hear you! So
incredible. You guys, what are we going to do now?
Dance.
We're going to dance, aren't we? We're all going to dance, aren't we? So you're going to invite all these folks out there to come up here and join you on this dance floor, right? Because we're getting ready to go. How much longer? Technical timeout here. Are you ready? You ready? Ladies and gentlemen, Patrick and Swayze.
Chick.